Welcome to group project number 2, where we investigate the logistic population growth for snails in a pond. We are given this equation in order to find our new snail population. However, it is important to remember that the equation only gives us the number of new snails, not the total population after the snails have been added. At a growth rate of 20%, we only see a couple of snails added within the first 2 weeks. We can expect the growth to look like a logistic model that evens out at the carrying capacity of 1,000 snails. How do the graphs change when the growth rate becomes larger? At a larger growth rate at 50%, the carrying capacity reaches 1,000 at almost 15 weeks, rather than the 45 weeks reached at 20%. At an even higher growth rate of 150%, the peak of the slope is reached much quicker, and the population capacity is reached almost half of 15 weeks. At an even larger rate of 250%, as the snails reach the carrying capacity, the logistic model is lost, and the data becomes much more sporadic.
This graph looks like an exponential at first for only 52 weeks. It never reaches carrying capacity in that time. But if it went for more than a year or so, or a longer period of time, eventually it would look like a logistic growth model.
For the large growth rate, can the population be stabilized by starting with an initial population very near the carrying capacity? So in the first graph, we can see when the rate of growth is at 150% and the initial population is 999, the carrying capacity is reached just after 2 years. In the second graph, when the rate of growth is 250% with the initial population of 999, the carrying capacity is reached rather quickly but begins to fluctuate approximately between 500 and 1,250 as the weeks progress. And when the rate of growth is at 350% with the initial population of 999, the population drops to zero right around the 7-year mark. So the population was stabilized when we had an initial population of 999 and the growth rate of 150%.